What's next on Nickeloedon?
I don't know.
You can't do that on television. Next. If these were your clothes, or if this were your room, boy, would you be in trouble. But not on Finders Keepers.
Let's take a look at it.
This is Nick territory. So as long as you're a kid, you can do anything you want.
Find it.
Like shred Sherlock study, dig up the beach, even sweat it out in the swamp.
There's a lot of places you can look.
At Finders Keepers, you get it so gunky, even kid stars can't stay away. So if you want to mess around, check out Finders Keepers. Weekdays at 6, 5 Central on the only network for you, Nickeloedon. Hey, dude, what do you think of Ted?
I count on Ted's experience. It's usually a big mistake, but I do it.
Yeah, we're tight. We guys got to stick together.
Ted who?
You gotta like the guy.
Do I know Ted? Whenever things go wrong, I turn to Ted. Because it's probably his fault.
Are you sure you don't mean Ned or Fred?
Ted. Part of the gang here on Hey Dude.
Oh, Ted McGriff. Never heard of him.
Only on Nickeloedon.
I like Nickeloedon because it always makes me laugh.
I don't know. I just like it a lot. They have great stories on it.
It's fun. It's enjoyable. You learn things from it. It makes you laugh. Which is great.
Well, like, because a lot of times they'll show kids what are really neat things or really weird things or really funny things.
I watch it because sometimes there's nothing better to do.
Yeah,
it's just cool.
I don't know, it's just Nickeloedon has all different kinds of neat things. It's just what I want.
Nothing makes cherished children's stories so enjoyable and memorable as having them come magically to life in quality videos. The Parent Care Home Video Series of Children's Classics has put together a library of the most entertaining and worthwhile stories. Stories that will have your children laughing and learning, including full-length feature films from studios like Walt Disney and 20th Century Fox. And right now, as a special introductory offer, call and order Charlotte's Web, a full-length film for just $9.99, a savings of over 30%. Keep it, and other videos will follow each month for just $14.99. Your children will enjoy and remember all the stories that came magically to life in the Parent Care Children's Classic Series. As Alice said,
in my world, the books will be nothing but pictures.
Parent Care Home Videos, for parents who care about their children.
Call 1-800-962-6400 now and order Charlotte's Web at the special $9.99 price. Charge it by calling 1-800-962-6400. This Saturday, brace yourself for the most important moment in Lassie history.
What's this all about?
Find out in a five-hour special, Saturday, starting at 9, 8 Central on Nick.
Mix up some Hershey's chocolate milk mix. And find out what really chocolatey chocolate milk is all about. From Hershey, the chocolate people.
Price for the next 10 minutes.
Out of my way! I got bargain fever! Oh, we'll take this.
I do believe that's $6.39.
Great, we'll take two of them.
Okay, anything else?
Yeah, we'll take 10 pairs of those oversized overalls.
Okay.
Oh, Mom.
And then some moms only let you buy clothes that are practical. Yes, now those clothes are durable. You will grow into them.
Listen to your mother.
Thank you, doll. And they're comfortable, aren't they?
Yeah, but I
mean... Well, that settles it. Now let's go and get you some new saddle shoes.
And then there are moms who humiliate you in front of the whole store.
Okay, now this dress will do until you lose all that weight you gained at your grandmother's. Oh, and those overalls are totally wrong. They make you look like a blimp.
And no bright colors until your acne clears up.
Okay, now, let's just go home.
Even when you're at home, you still can't escape the tacky taste of your parents.
This lovely velour leisure suit is a Shopping Network bargain for a mere $15. Call now and we'll throw in this free handsome sharkskin jacket and six pairs of corduroy bell bottoms.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy! I need that jacket! Hello? Hello?
Hey, and if worse comes to worse, you could ask your parents to transfer you to a school where you wear a uniform. Hey, it beats earth tones and polyesters. All this talk about health foods and avoiding foods with additives has really confused us. So Matt here decided to do some investigating and gave us a report. Matt, just what exactly is an additive?
Oh, an additive, Catherine, is anything they add to food before you buy it.
Oh, are all additives bad for you?
Not all additives are bad for you. As a matter of fact, scientists test every additive before it goes on the market to make sure it's not harmful. Oh. They test it with laboratory rats, kind of like Ed Ratface over here.
Oh, he's cute!
Hey, better stay back, he bites. Well, he's very hungry, you see. I can't feed him until I'm ready to do all my tests. Now let's test an additive on Ed, and I'll show you that he's really very gentle. Ready, Ed? Good. Now some additives, like salt, are preservatives. Salt helps preserve potato chips. Watch this. For example, pucker up, Ed. There we go. I have some potato chips.
Well, what's wrong with him? Was there something the matter with the salt?
Oh, no, but it did make him thirsty. You want some OJ, Ed? There, some OJ for you. Now, other additives add texture to food, like emulsifiers, which give Jell-O its bounce. Jell-O. He loves those emulsifiers. It's tough being a laboratory rat. Now, another kind of additive is acids, like carbonic acid, which give soda its fizz. Just shake this up a little bit, and some carbonic acid. Have some of that. Now, that's what gives soda its fizz. Now, another additive is one used to give food a new color, like red dye number two. Which they add in certain candies, like those, and hot dogs. I'm a hot dog there, Ed. Stick that through there. Oh no! I forgot! That additive was taken off the market because it was proved to kill laboratory rats. Oh no. Wait, he's all right. He's all right. I guess he actually didn't drink enough to die.
Guess so.
Uh-oh. Of course, there are some side effects. Wow. Anyway, finally. Wow, must be from the carbonic acid. Anyway, finally, we have vitamin D, which is put in things like milk to give it more nutrition. Like this. And have some of that milk. And look how strong it makes them. Wow, he picks up that cheese no problem. That is real strong.
Yeah. Well, thank you, Matt, for that very interesting report.
Oh, my pleasure. Thank you very much.
Sure. And now it's time for our special guest.
Our next guest is a big star in Australia and has been imported to the U.S. Let's take a look at his movie, Young Einstein. please welcome Yahoo Serious. Watch that step over there.
So, yeah, it's a big one.
Yeah, I meant to tell you before.
That's g'day.
G'day. Wow, that's great. I have a question. I was just watching that clip, and how do you do that with your eyebrows? You're moving them all around, and how do you do that?
Oh, you get special false eyebrows on.
Ah. Yeah.
And trick ears, you get those as well.
Trick ears?
Yeah.
You just go into a store and buy trick ears?
Yeah, there's no problem with
great.
It.
Great.
You know, I have had a problem here. I went out last night and had some spaghetti, and it got all over my pants here.
Kind of looks like they threw up on you.
Yeah, well, I don't know. I'm a really messy eater. It's a problem.
Really? Well, where do you pick out your clothes? Because those are pretty interesting, if you ask me.
No, these are just standard Australian clothes.
So this is like, if you went to a private school in Australia, this is what the uniform would be? I mean, it's like that standard?
Yeah, this is probably a little bit conservative. It gets a bit wilder than that.
It's a bit conservative. Now, how do you figure that matches? Do you just say the flowers and the spaghetti just go together?
Yeah, well, what brings them together is the spots on the socks.
Oh, I see. So the socks match the whole...
Well, you got to have a bit of dress sense, you know? Yeah.
Definitely, I see. Now, you just did a movie, Young Einstein. Could you just tell us a little bit of what it's about?
Well, it's a sort of like a story about the greatest scientist of all time. But he's a pretty young guy, and he grew up on a remote island off the southern coast of Australia called Tasmania. Mm-hmm. And in 1905, he invents the theory of relativity. In 1906, he invents rock and roll. So
they're close, relativity and rock and roll.
And the world's first electric guitar. It was a pretty wild guy. And the world's first surfboard.
Wow. Now, how did you know all this about Einstein? I mean, did you have to study him? I mean, is this all made up?
Well, what I was doing, I was traveling down the Amazon River in South America.
Something you do daily?
Usually, you know, it's a okay. thing.
Start off the morning with a little.
Yeah. And this guy on the Amazon River had this T-shirt of this great scientist, Albert Einstein, on his 72nd birthday poking his tongue out. There was a picture of him poking his tongue out. Uh-huh. And I thought, well, anyone at the age of 72 who pokes his tongue out, it's probably worth, you know, making a movie about him. So away we went, you know.
And you wrote, produced, directed, starred in, and he did his own stunts, too.
Yeah, but my mother did the catering.
So how come your mom was usually to hire some big company to do the catering? How come your mom did it?
No one cooks better than your mother, you know that.
That's true. So you just needed her there all the time so you could eat really well?
Yeah, basically, yeah.
Now, what's your favorite food when you're working on a movie to eat?
Well, I like spaghetti, but I think I'll give up after last night, you know?
Yeah. You know, I think a good dry cleaning can get that off. But,
yeah?
You know, I'm not sure. So she cooks, like, the whole... She didn't mind at all?
No, you know what mothers are like. You bring extra people home, they just cook. So I just bought the whole film crew home.
I see. And I heard they also, like, you all stayed in one big house?
Yeah, my grandfather's house.
Yeah. He let the whole crew stay there?
Yeah, it was pretty wild.
How long were you there?
Well, we were there about a month, I guess. We moved around. We filmed all over Australia and some stuff in Paris. So it's set, like, all over the world. Uh-huh. There's some fantastic scenes in there. Mm-hmm. But, you know, it was just amazing that everyone kind of stayed together when we were making it.
Mm-hmm. Now, also, your stunts in the movie, they're like, what was the hardest stunt you had to do?
Well, there's a few of them. There was one where I climbed this cliff, which is a couple of thousand foot tall, without any ropes or anything. But the really hard thing about it was I had to eat apples at the same time. You know?
Oh, yeah, I can see what that means. Now, you eat apples a lot. Do you like apples?
I love apples.
Albert Einstein's family was apple farmers?
They were, yeah.
Yeah?
Yep.
So in the whole movie, he's eating apples the entire time.
My mum in the movie eats a lot more. My dad's 8 foot tall in the movie, and my mum's 8 foot wide. You saw some of her dancing there.
Yeah, pretty interesting. Now, do you watch a lot of cartoons? Because when I was watching the movie, I mean, you did a lot of things, like you had the Tasmanian Devil.
Yeah.
In there, and you did, like, stunts that seemed like from cartoons. Do you watch a lot of them?
Yeah, constantly. There's a lot of filmmakers saying my main influence was this novelist or my main influence was this filmmaker. My main influence was like cartoons. So. Yeah.
Now, do you watch Australian cartoons?
Yeah, I watch a lot of American cartoons, too. Yeah, we have a lot of Australian cartoons.
Do they have them like kangaroos?
Yeah, you can't move for kangaroos. That's the biggest problem in Australian filmmaking, to keep the animals out of the shots.
Oh, I see.
So every shot in Young Einstein has got an animal in, and I refuse to do a scene without any kids in it. So there's always kids and animals around, which was kind of really great.
Yeah, all right, well, we have to go to commercial, and there's probably lots of kids and animals in the commercial, but when we come back, Yahoo's still going to be with us, and we're going to be doing our hair, so stay tuned.
Don't just sit there. We'll be right back after these messages.
Kellogg's Pop Tarts. So hot, they're cool. So cool, they're hot. The taste of real fruit, real hot, 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 hot. Hot Pop Tarts. So hot, they're cool, so cool.
You can get ready for something wild when you bite into new Kellogg's Pop-Tarts. Because now Pop-Tarts have even more fruit filling for a taste that's better than ever.
Get ready for a special Sports Illustrated sneak preview.
It's unreal. The man, it's like he's from another planet.
You never know what he's going to do.
He doesn't even know. He just does it, and you're like, duh.
They just saw an amazing video cassette presented by Sports Illustrated, starring the most exciting figure in sports today.
Who else? Jordan.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. He's unbelievable.
Michael Jordan, Come Fly With Me 1990. Over 40 minutes of the game's ultimate playmaker. Yours free with your paid subscription to SI.
Yes!
Call toll-free and get 26 issues of SI at over 45% off the cover price.
I didn't realize you could save that much.
Including SI's blockbuster baseball preview, the giant 35th anniversary covers issue, and the red hot swimsuit issue.
So what's the catch?
No catch. You get it all for just 3 monthly installments of $12.97 each. Even use your credit card.
Golden. Let's do it.
Save over 45% and get the Jordan video free.
You're going to be giving away a lot of these babies starting right here.
You're watching Nickeloedon. And now back to Don't Just Sit There.
I'm all right, Mary. They're only electrons.
Hi, welcome back. We're here with Yahoo Serious. And what exactly are we going to be doing here?
Well, we're going to be conducting a scientific experiment, Matt. We're going to actually get a number of American kids to do the first Einstein haircuts in America.
All right. So we're going to have like a contest?
Why not?
Okay. Well, how do you do your hair?
Well, what you do at the start of the week, you just turn upside down like that, and you get anything. You get some, you get some gel, or you get some, you know, hairspray, anything
jelly.
Like that. Jelly, you know, mud, anything, and just rub it into your hair.
Uh-huh.
And then you just go around. And then that night you go to bed, and the next morning you get up. It's a little bit messier than when you went to sleep. And then every morning you go to bed. Every night you go to bed. Every morning you get up. It's a little bit better. This is about 4 days worth.
So it actually gets better as time goes on.
Yeah.
All right, now we got some kids from the audience, and why don't we bring them on out? They're going to be our Yahoo lookalikes. So why don't you come on out, guys? Come on, run out. Come on, let's go. All right, turn around. All right, now why don't we go down and get each of your names, first of all. What's your name?
Chris.
Mindy.
Danielle.
Mike.
Sandra.
And Sandra. Okay, now they're all ready, and they all want to look like Yahoo. So we have outfits here with T-shirts. So you guys are going to turn around, put these on, flip upside down, we have brushes and hairspray and stuff like that here. You try and get your hair looking like his, and we're gonna have a time limit, right?
Well, I don't know about a time limit. What if I sort of jump around here like a kangaroo if I went around, and what if every time I get around once, what if the audience counted?
Counted?
Say to 10.
Okay, so each lap is 1, then 2, and then 3. Okay, so you guys, are you nervous here, Mike?
Yeah.
You're nervous? All right, so you get in your starting position, and we'll get ready to go. On your mark, you can't turn around yet. You gotta wait. All right. On your mark, get set. No, hold on. On your mark, get set. Go, go. All right, Yahoo. Like a kangaroo, as he swiftly moves around the studio, and you gotta put the shirt on. Oh, she seems to have gotten the shirt on first. All right, next is his pants with the big suspenders. I seem to be helping her out. All right, go. No, we don't count to 2 until he goes around again. Nice try, though. All right, he's got the shorts on. All right, you nervous? Well, keep up that pace. You're doing pretty well there. Come on, put on the pants. Don't worry if it's straight. Go. All right, now bend over and do your hair. All right. Oh, look at her. All right, now put your head down. Spray it with lots of stuff. Here, I'm going to help you here. There you go. All right, now try and make it stick up and straight. Here, watch this. Maybe this will work. Boo! 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 Alright, stop making her hair stand up. Yahoo, who do you think is doing the best so far?
I think we're doing pretty well here, Matt.
Oh, pretty good. So how do you feel? You think you're doing the best? You excited?
Yes.
Alright, keep going. This is great. Oh, wait, I'm just gonna get her. this here and get some of this. All right, move around. Pretty big steps there, Yahoo.
Yeah. Yes, yeah, this is a Tasmanian kangaroo.
Tasmanian kangaroo. And those are different from Australian kangaroos, huh?
Very different, very different.
Yeah, I see. All right, now what if I just, like, do you mind?
Halfway, Matt, how
are
they doing?
They're doing pretty well. I think the girl in the end has it pretty good. She's got it. The boys seem to be having a little trouble, but maybe if they sped up a little, they could get it going.
I think we'll put a bit of pressure on.
All right, he's running. Tip your head over, bend down and do it. Bend down and get your hair to stick up. All right, here you go. Let's try and get some of this. Pretty good. Slow down, Yahoo. They can't do it this fast. Go. Not that slow. Go. Just go. Oh, she hit me in the face with a hairspray. Keep going. Don't worry about it. There's one more lap. Guys, gotta hurry. Bend down and do it. Make your hair stick up. Oh, she got it. Oh, this must hurt. They're like pulling out their hair here. Oh, so Yahoo stops to give a little help to some of the kids from the audience here. Now, I think you gotta give equal help to all of them, Yahoo, otherwise, it's not really fair to them.
That's a good one,
that looks
good.
Wow.
Toothbrush.
My toothbrush.
Fantastic. Right,
how do you feel? You feel you're doing good? There's only half a lap left. You ready?
Yeah.
You think you're gonna win?
I hope so.
Well, we'll see you in a minute. Come on, Yahoo. There he goes. Stop. No more spraying.
Wow.
All right. Now, do you want to judge, or do you want to have the audience clap for who they think is the best?
I think the audience should judge.
All right, so I'm going to hold my hand over all of them, and when you think that they're the best, whoever you think is the best, clap the most for. All right? This one, you think he looks like Yahoo? Okay, pretty good. Not that bad. How about you? This one? Come on. I think she's a little ahead. He's got short hair. What do you want? He did the back of it for like half an hour. He was trying to get it, but. Oh, be nice. Just clap a little. All right. And her? Like that? Okay, so I think the winner is right here. Let's have a round of applause. What's your name?
Mindy.
Or Mindy. Yeah, round of applause, Mindy. And what do we have for them, Yahoo?
Well, you know, I was looking at it all. They've all got different types of hair.
Uh-huh.
And I reckon they're all winners in a weird way.
Well, that's very true. They are all winners.
I mean, you don't really know with an Einstein haircut until it gets, like they'll go home. At the end of the day, it'll be a bit better. If they sleep on it tonight, they'll wake up in the morning and be perfect.
So maybe in a week, we should have them come back and see who's the best.
Exactly.
Maybe, okay.
But what about... This is the Young Einstein soundtrack. I think we'll give everyone a copy of that on a cassette.
All right, so why don't we give it to them? And not only that, but they get to look like Yahoo for the rest of the day. And if they don't wash their hair, the rest of the week.
Yes.
And who knows,
maybe a
month. Well, thank you very much for coming, Yahoo. Let's hear it for Yahoo Serious.
You'll never guess what I've been doing. I followed Matt and Mary around all week just to record those really embarrassing things that people do when they're alone. This is Matt, alone at a restaurant.
Would Monsieur care for a toothpick?
Perhaps he needs a Kleenex.
No, thanks. I was just getting up.
How disgusting! Now, then I caught Mary talking to herself while putting on makeup in the dressing room.
Look at this face. Where is my mascara? Oh, well. Some blush. Okay. Okay, some lipstick. Like a goddess. Mwah!
Oh, very funny, Catherine. Oh, that's a major crack up. Ha ha ha.
Ha ha. I'm only kidding, you guys. What is it? What's wrong?
Well, how would you like it if someone, like, photographed you all day, huh? And you were alone.
You guys, come on. I can't believe you're picking your nose.
Yeah, well, look who forgot to turn the camcorder off when they were watching TV.
Ha ha ha! Ha ha, watch this!
Yeah!
The next award is for the best new actress on a variety television show. And the winner is...
Catherine Featherston! It's such a thrill, I cannot tell you. It was such an honor just to be nominated. But winning is even better. I'd like to thank my parents, my grandparents, my first grade teacher, my cat, my dog, my first acting teacher, my producer, my director, and of course my great co-hosts, Matt and Mary. Although I'll be really sad when I have to leave to do my spin-off show, The Catherine Featherston Show! Yay! Oh, thank you so much! Thank you!
Yay! Oh, could you just say that last line again, that Catherine Show?
That was funny.
We got you.
All right. I guess it's safe to say that everybody does some pretty embarrassing stuff when they're alone.
Which is why they do it alone in the first place.
Yeah, without nosy people like you around.
Okay, I get the message.
Oh, well, we gotta go smash Catherine's video camera to a pulp, so that's our show for today. We'd like to thank our special guest, Yahoo Serious, our band, and our wonderful studio audience. And remember, whether you're experimenting on a rat or spying on your friends...
Looking.
Find it.
You'll find Finders Keepers next on Nickeloedon. Hey, dude. What do you think of Bradley?
She's okay, I guess. For a girl.
Confidentially, she's crazy about me.
She's a rotten waitress.
Okay, well, she likes me.
She's my best friend. Although it hasn't always been easy.
She once smiled at me.
She's good with the horses.
Brad. Part of the gang here on Hey Dude.
She hates me.
Only on Nickeloedon. If you love Lassie, make sure you tune to Nick this Saturday morning. Because the most important moment in Lassie history is about to happen, and Nickeloedon wants you there.
You're waiting for something, aren't you?
Unless you see it for yourself, unless you hear it for yourself, you just won't believe it.
I wish somebody'd tell me something.
From this day forward, things will never be the same. It's a heart-stopping 5-hour Lassie saga all Saturday morning, starting at 9, 8 central on Nickeloedon. This event is brought to you by Ralston Purina's Batman cereal.
Tired of being treated like an animal?
Bringing up a child is much like training a dog.
Tired of getting the short end of the stick just because you're a kid?
One for you, three for me.
Then throw off your shackles and join the revolution on Nickeloedon. Under our proud orange flag, we're rampaging through toy stores, infiltrating schools, even taking over cities.
We're surviving!
So demand kid justice and leave the grown-ups quaking in their boots. Join the revolution on Nickeloedon, the network that gives you what you want.
Could be something to it.
Ben Randall, commenting on Time Life's Mysteries of the Unknown.
I've always been a little curious about unexplained phenomena.
Ever sense when something's about to happen?
Well, yeah, but...
Ever experienced deja vu?
Sort of. Like, I went into this 19th century farmhouse, and I just knew I'd been there before.
In another life?
I'm not ready for that.
Ready for this?
Mystic places?
talks about the Nazca lines being runways for alien spaceships and aliens interbreeding with ancient Peruvians.
Did they?
Read the book. Read about Aleister Crowley and his bride's honeymoon night in the Great Pyramid.
What happened?
Read the book.
I'm ready to order.
The books?
And the food.
Waiter?
To order Mystic Places, call 1-800-638-1800. Examine it for 10 days. Keep it and pay $12.99 plus shipping and handling. Other books will follow, one about every other month. Keep only the ones you want. Cancel any time. Call 1-800-638-1800.
3:30. You've just survived 7 hours of math, history, and cafeteria slop. Hold on. Nickeloedon has relief waiting for you at home. Super Sloppy Double Dare. Every school day at 3:30. 3:30 when your day needs a lift. 3:30 when you want to blow off some steam. 3:30 when your brain is so fried you can serve it on a bun. Start your afternoon post-school recovery with Super Sloppy Double Dare. Just when you need it most. Every school day at 3:30, 2:30 Central. On the network that has what you want. Nickeloedon.
If you like building blocks or know someone who does, you're gonna want these. The Flexi Blocks, the blocks that move. Only Flexi Blocks have this patented design to make every block move. Not just one or two special pieces. Because Flexi Blocks move, any project is more fun and exciting. Dinosaurs grab, cars race, bulldozers roll. You can even make things to wear. Flexi Blocks have won 4 major awards for excellence. Now, with this special Factory Direct TV offer, you get all these pieces. Satisfaction guaranteed. Order your Flexi Blocks now and get this storage pail. Start building like never before with Flexi Blocks, the blocks that move.
Order Flexi Blocks for $19.95 plus $4 shipping and handling. Grown-ups only can call 1-800-662-1400 or write Flexi Blocks, P.O. Box 7140, Berkeley, California. This is a special Factory Direct TV offer. Sorry, no CODs. In California, add sales tax. That's 1-800-662-1400 for Flexi Blocks, the blocks that move.
Atta boy. Whoa. Hey, let's go, Charlie.